few weeks ago, the Detroit Tigers made the first big-time move of free agency, signing Eduardo Rodriguez to a 5-year, $77 million contract with an opt-out clause after the second year of it. Rodriguez had spent a number of years with the Red Sox before being scooped up by the Tigers early in free agency this offseason. Rodriguez's outings had previously split the Red Sox fan base, as his base stats were very subpar, like ERA sitting at 4.74, WHIP, although it wasn't terribly bad, and other baseline stats. On the other hand, Rodriguez's season stood out to advanced stats nerds, making the payment from the Tigers make a little more sense. But enough about the signing. This is Noah from Grandstand Productions, and this is about Eduardo Rodriguez's journey throughout the Red Sox organization. In 2014, the Eduardo Rodriguez era in Boston had officially begun, when the Red Sox acquired a then 21-year-old Rodriguez for a 29-year-old left-handed reliever named Andrew Miller. Miller only ended up pitching 20 innings for the Orioles, and as we know, Rodriguez ended up pitching a ton more than 20 innings for the Red Sox. Now, let's get into some more about the lefty that the Orioles required for Rodriguez. Having said earlier, the Orioles only got 20 innings out of Miller, but Miller was pretty dominant for Baltimore nonetheless. Miller then, in 2016, joined the Yankees, where he would pitch for about a year and a half and, of course, be dominant, before heading over to Cleveland. Miller, from 2013 to 2017, was arguably one of the most dominant relievers in baseball, capping it off with a 1.44 ERA in 2017 and a World Series appearance in those years. In 2018, however, Miller just lost his touch, posting a 4.24 ERA, followed up by a 4.65 ERA in 2019 with the Cardinals. Miller was okay in 2020, but 60 games is hard to judge by. Miller proved that in 2021 by posting a 4.75 ERA. Miller went from one of the most dominant relievers to one of the most washed in the span of a single offseason. Anyways, let's see what the Red Sox got out of Eduardo Rodriguez. In 2015, Rodriguez made his Red Sox debut, and he did not disappoint. The 22-year-old left-hander threw 7.2 scoreless innings for the Red Sox in a 5-1 win over the Texas Rangers. Erod that year went on to post a 3.85 ERA in 121.2 innings pitched. Rodriguez took a few steps back in 2016 and 2017, posting a 4.71 ERA in 2016 and a 4.19 ERA in 2017. Erod's fortunes picked up once again in 2018, where the Venezuelan racked up a 3.82 ERA in 129.2 innings pitched. Also in 2018, Erod also won his first and thus far only World Series ring in defeating the Dodgers. 2018 was the then best season of his career, but that wouldn't be for long, as in 2019, Rodriguez was Boston's best starter, hurling 203.1 innings pitched, finishing 6th in the American League Cy Young voting, and posting a 19-6 record with a 3.81 ERA and a 1.33 WHIP in 34 starts. However, Rodriguez's good fortunes would come to an end in come 2020. In 2020, Eduardo Rodriguez did not pitch, as he was diagnosed with a severe heart condition related to COVID-19. Rodriguez, however, was luckily able to make a comeback in the 2021 season. In 2021, as previously mentioned, Rodriguez had the Red Sox fan base split. Advanced numbers-wise, it was the best season of his career. Baseline numbers-wise, it was the worst, posting a 4.74 ERA. Towards the end of the season, Rodriguez gave the Red Sox a consistent few outings, especially at home against the Astros in the ALCS, where he mocked Carlos Correa's "my time" gesture. We didn't know it at the time, but that was the turning point of the ALCS, and it was also the last time we saw Erod pitch in a Red Sox uniform. Losing Rodriguez hurts, but the signings of Michael Wacha, James Paxton, and Rich Hill certainly make up for the void left by Erod, as well as the voids left by Garrett Richards and Martin Perez. We will cover all of the moves made by Chaim Bloom and the Red Sox in our next video. So there you have it. Hopefully we took you on a little trip down memory lane, remembering Eduardo Rodriguez's time here in Boston. If you like this video, please feel free to hit that subscribe button, like the video, share the video with your friends, and also give us a follow on Twitter at GrandstandProd. Hopefully we'll see you next time on Grandstand Productions. Go Red Sox!